Standard 7 English Medium Biology Chapter 2. In the last video we learn about the nutrition, what is digestion, ingestion, etc. Mode of the ingestion, mode of intake of the food, etc. Now also we learn about the digestive tract, which is known as alimentary canal, and which are the different parts of that alimentary canal, like the buccal cavity, oesophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, etc. Now along with that we have to learn about the digestive system. Digestive system means we already learn about the digestive tract, in which from the buccal cavity to anus there is a long connected tract which is known as alimentary canal. Now the digestive tract means that alimentary canal and the associated glands, means some glands are associated with it, they constitute the digestive system. Now which are the associative glands? They are salivary glands, which are inside our mouth, the liver somewhere in the cavity of the stomach, and the pancreas that is also related, connected with our digestive tract, means that alimentary canal. So these, the salivary glands, the liver and the pancreas, they are the glands which are not connected with the alimentary canal, means the food does not pass through them, but they are helping by secreting the digestive juices. They secrete some digestive juice which helps in the digestion of the food. So the digestive tract means the alimentary canal along with those three glands, salivary glands which are in the mouth, the other two, the pancreas and the liver inside the abdomen cavity, they together create the digestive system. Now one by one we have to learn about the different sections of the digestive system from the buccal cavity. We start the mouth and buccal cavity. The mouth and buccal cavity. Now in our mouth we start eating. We take the food and put it in the mouth, which is known as ingestion also. Now what happens? We chew the food with teeth in the mouth. There are teeth in the mouth. You know about the teeth, you learn about them in the lower standards also, that when we born we don't have teeth, then in few years you get the teeth which are known as milk teeth, because after few years they will fall down one by one, one by one, and then you will get a new set of teeth which are known as permanent teeth, which you will keep it a long time until you get older. So the milk teeth means that those teeth which you get when you are smaller, then they will fall down and you get the permanent teeth. So we chew the food with teeth and break them into smaller pieces. You know that when we chew the food, it is in the big pieces. So when we start chewing, then it is cutting and grinding and piercing, and lots of things is doing with the teeth. We have different types of teeth in our buccal cavity, and we can see that in the picture also that there is a different tooth here for the different things. Like so here you can see that these are different teeth, the name also, that molar teeth and the premolar, canine and incisor. So different, like incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Molar and premolar are like for the grinding, and others, some of them are used for cutting, piercing and make the small pieces like that. So different teeth are there in our body, in our buccal cavity, which do the different type of work of cutting, chewing, piercing and grinding. Generally the molar are using for the grinding because they are making the food very very grinding and fine powder like that. So now when we start chewing, what happens? The food is getting smaller and smaller, and along with that the salivary gland that is inside our buccal cavity, they secrete some digestive juice. About that you will learn in the future, but here we have to only remember that the saliva is secreted by the salivary glands. They secrete the juice which is known as saliva. For example, what is saliva actually? When we hear about our favorite food, or if you smell somewhere there is cooking and that is your favorite food, what happens to your mouth? Your mouth is getting watered. Apne kehne ke moma pani aavi gayo. That is actually that saliva secreted from the salivary glands. So what is the use of that saliva? Saliva have some chemicals which break down the starch into sugar. You know about the starch. Starch is the one type of carbohydrate. So when there is a starch in the food, is getting digested in the buccal cavity by the saliva, and it turns into sugar. You know that. Now you will understand. When you eat like rotis or puri, bakri, etc., then when you chew it for a long time, then at the end you will feel sweet. Taste will be sweet. When you eat a roti, it is not sweet. But when you start chewing, and then at last when it is fine, very fine, saliva also getting mixed with it, then at the end, if you didn't notice, you must notice now when you eat rotis. But chew it properly for a long time, not like chew little and you swallow, then you won't taste sweet. So you have to chew it properly, then at the end you will feel that the sugar taste is there. Because saliva break down the starch and make sugar from it, and you know the taste of sugar is sweet. So now that is the work of the salivary glands inside our buccal cavity. In your buccal cavity there is another organ is also there, which is a fleshy muscular, that is our tongue, which is connected at the back part and it is free in the front part, so we can move it according to our desire inside. What is the function of this tongue? The tongue is a fleshy muscular organ in buccal cavity. It mixes the saliva with the food when we chew the food. You will notice that the tongue is also getting moved, because it mixes the food with the saliva, so that the food can be properly mixed with the saliva. Because the saliva is not only breaking down the carbohydrate, I mean the starch into sugar, but it also helps to make the food wet. Because if the food is wet, it is easy to swallow through our food pipe here. Therefore, the saliva is doing two works. First, it breaking down the starch into sugar, and also it make the food wet, so that when we swallow it, we don't have to struggle to swallow. When it is wet, it can be skipped very easily through the digestive tract. Now the tongue, as I told you, it mixes saliva with the food, and when we chew the food, also the use of tongues are different also. Not only for the mixing the saliva we use the tongue, but when you talk, I hope you notice that when you're talking also your tongue is touching at different parts. Sometimes it's touching at the top, sometimes it's touching your teeth and so on. So when you talk also, If you think that there is tongue is not helping it, tongue is much helping. Without a tongue, you can't speak properly. Try to hold your tongue and then try to speak. Then you will notice that you can't speak properly. So the tongue is helping us in the talking also. Also, when you swallow the food, when you eat something, swallow the food. Look, your tongue is helpful that time also. Check properly that when you do the swallowing, that the tongue is helping in you also. So that now we talk about that saliva, which break down the starch into sugar. Now you know that starch, what is the taste of the starch? How do we taste that there is a starch in the food item? We take the iodine solution. When we put the drops of iodine solution on the food containing starch, it will turn blue-black. It shows that there is starch present in that food item. Now, do one thing. Take the starch solution in a test tube, which is available in the laboratory. Then, what we have to do? We have to gather some saliva from the mouth. And then, from that little saliva, you can add to that starch solution. Or you can take boiled rice also in one, and in another one also, you can do that thing like that. And then, if you check that the rice is containing starch, and therefore, that will turn into blue-black. But now, it is looking different, disgusting, but if you want to do, you can do it. That we have to take two test tubes, or only one, two test tubes. In first, just take the boiled rice and put the iodine drops, then it will turn blue-black. Now, for second test tube, what we have to do? We have to take some rice and chew it little, so that the saliva mixes properly. And then you have to take it out back and put it in the test tube. And then you again put the iodine drop. Then you will see that in this test tube, second test tube, the iodine will not change the color. It will remain as it is color, golden yellow color. Why? Because when we chew it, when you chew that rice, the starch in the rice is already converted into sugar, and sugar does not give you the blue-black color, and therefore it is not getting turned blue. It means that the starch is already digested. Therefore, from this we can understand that saliva is very, very useful for the digestion of the starch. Now we were talking about the tongue. There is another important work of the tongue also. You know that our tongue is detecting the taste also. Because in our tongue, there are some places which are known as taste buds. And these taste buds detect the different tastes like sweet, sour, bitter, or spicy, etc. That are detected by the taste buds, which is also in the tongue that we are having. Right? So, in this video, we learn about the tooth and the tongue and the mouth, buccal cavity, salivary glands also. Now, you already learn about the tooth decay also. You know that when you eat lots of chocolate, your parents or the elders will say, don't eat too much chocolates. You will lose your teeth. But actually, it is not due to that chocolate. But if you don't keep your tooth clean, then what happens? The small particles of the food will remain in the very small gaps. And then the worms or the microorganisms, they will eat that food and they will produce some chemicals which can destroy the tooth, which is known as tooth decay. Then your tooth are getting worse, turning black. You will feel that when you eat something, when you drink a very cold item, you will get that sensation. And therefore, you have to take care of your tooth. After eating, you have to clean them using the toothpaste so that you can have your healthy eat. So we are going to end the video here. Any confusion, you have to write down in the comment section. Along with this, we will get a PDF file in which whatever is there, you have to write down in your notebook. Thank you very much.